government screen presents us with information regarding our...
Hello there, dear viewers. This is Trestle242, and welcome to Stellaris. It's time for another episode with the strange Mengeti aliens. And, well, we're running low on energy credits, so I think it would be good to try to get them somehow. I mean, we have our colony here on Pudanus, which is, we're still working on colonizing, but when it is done, I think that we would be able to have some nice some power plants on there. And then it would be nice to maybe colonize Othana. I mean, there are so many places we could colonize. And I think that we need another science ship, maybe, since we have quite a lot of minerals. So I'm going to just, you know, start up the game and see what I can do. I have a construction ship that isn't doing much. There are a lot of minerals here in Fauterra. And I think, was there something I was going to build here? Well, I don't think so. I could build it here. Around the star. Oh, I already have a mining station around. Yes, it looks like it's orbiting the star. Oh, okay. Because the construction ship is not doing anything as of yet. Might send it out to Fauterra. Let's see what I can build there. Oh, minerals. That's good, that's good. And Pudanus is working hard. We can upgrade our lab to well, we can't, nothing that's good anyway.
Survey complete.
One system has been surveyed. It's not much there, some minerals, but whatever. And we're still losing a lot, which is unfortunate. There's not much in this area of space, unfortunately. And we still haven't met any neighbors, which is worrying. We can definitely afford another colony ship, though. Let's build a Mengeti colony. And why not another science ship? And we cannot upgrade our spaceport yet because I haven't researched that technology. So, okay. They are building. And Pudanus is slowly colonizing itself. It might take some time. That is why we're running low on energy credits, I believe. And the Tiyanki Space Whale? Well... the Tiyanki are friendly, so we shouldn't attack them. They won't do any harm. And I think it's so strange that we haven't found any aliens yet. Okay, this little fella is... still exploring. Well, that's fine. We're just waiting for things to happen, I suppose. I guess we can try to remove some of the tile blockers on the home planet.
Technology discovered.
Oh.
Survey complete.
Ooh, we can build orbital hydroponic farms. Interesting. Interesting, that sounds good. And now we can either build a gene clinic, which can make our populations more healthy, or we can make better farms. Or we can clear tile blockers. That one seems quite useful. So does this one, and so does that one. Well, I'll go with the cheapest one, the eco simulation. Better farms, that seems useful.
Anomaly detected.
Ooh. Impressive structures litter a small area on the surface. Oh, and there's an election of Enkef-1, practically begging for some archaeological work. Well, please research it, my friend.
Technology discovered.
Okay, so we have a bunch of different people who they might choose.
Colony established.
Yes! Pudana's home is built! Hooray! We shall build a basic power plant. Very useful. And a new ruler has been elected. Revered elder Siava Uvigalvav has been a ruler. And they will have a new election every 10 years. And unfortunately, the current Revere Elder has not fulfilled their campaign promises. Typical politician. We need a power plant here. What? Abandoned amusement park? The structures on NKF1 are not as old as we first believed. It seems to be a playground or amusement park of some sort. Science officer Huava Uliavan notes that many of the contraptions are highly complex creations that we can learn much from, and that, to the builder's alien eyes, this might have been a cutting-edge sensor array or even a gigantic art installation. Regardless, to us Mengeti, it looks mostly like a place where you would take your young and let them amuse themselves. Well, that's interesting, I suppose.
Construction complete.
And why not build yet another power plant? I mean, hey, power plants is good. A mine. It may seem like I'm building like crazy here, but it's always good to build. And now we can research something new. I think I shall research the improved spaceport. I think that will be very useful.
Survey complete.
Let's see. Prevere the governor on Kergaros 3 to become the next ruler. Okay. So who is our ruler?
The policies tab covers government policies as well as empire-wide edicts, practices that can be enforced by spending some of our influence.
Okay.
Construction complete.
Well, it seems to be okay. And we've finished building a science ship, I think it was, that we wanted to build. And wow, colony ships are quite cheap now. That's good. Maybe another corvette. And now we really do need a lot more energy. Let's see, what was I going to colonize? I had found a good planet. I mean, Thauetera? And then there is this one, Othana 3, which might be good. There's one in active building. Yes, it's because this population is still growing.
Construction complete.
A new faction has been recently gaining traction in the internal political landscape of the Mengeti Circle of Friends. Led by scientist Sevabav Uvimava, they call themselves the Alien Equality League. Their members have been pushing hard for friendly relations with alien species. A disgruntled faction will be a source of trouble, but one that approves of the government actions could prove useful. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. We don't mind. Colonizing takes time and costs a lot, but it's also very useful. Torelion is a quite... it's an okay planet, but we can't use much.
It anomaly has... detected.
Ooh. Some sort of anomaly. It doesn't say which one it is. But it will require extensive probing, but could garner a substantial find. Well, sure. Go ahead, research it, my friend. Oh no! A large group of faithless criminals from Halamanda have illegally converted a number of civilian starships into weapons of war. Operating on the fringes of our space, these heretics have started calling themselves the Regulators, and are responsible for several attacks against civilian shipping lanes. Their profane activities must not be allowed to continue. The faithful shall prevail. Yep. And I still don't know what to do. We have a bit of an energy crisis, and we haven't met anyone new yet so we can talk to. I mean, we can build
complete.
Something out there. Oh. Well, hello there, my friend. I would like you to go over there and attack them. Explosions in the sky. The planet Briscoll 1 is the home of a marvel of nature. Giant colorful explosions appear in the sky, a result of the chemical composition of the atmospheres reacting to the sun's gamma rays. Students and senior scientists alike are spreading this find like a wildfire. It has generated quite a spark of interest for the scientific fields amongst our people. Interesting. That sounds very good. I like it. Go on then. We need to fight these bloody pirates.
Station under attack.
Oh no, they're fighting. Oh man, they're removing the... Ah, these are terrible. Well, our ships are coming to fight these pirates. They cannot. They cannot do this. We must fight them. Cannot allow them to continue. They are almost destroying our research center. No. Can we fight back? Can we kill them? No.
Technology discovered.
Well, we have gotten more research speed, I guess that's
research
good.
Research station lost.
Oh man, that's very bad. I think we'll have to do the basic combat rolls, which I think means that we can make better computers for our battleships, which is good. And I also think that we must recruit a general. Let's see, recruit. How do I recruit? Oh dear. They just keep freaking blowing our things up. Stop being such jerks. You absolute dicks. Why would you do that?
We survey have... complete.
I mean, I don't understand why. Maybe I need to take someone from planet Earth. Simple as that. Since we have a big energy shortage. He is not growing very well. Let's do this.
Technology discovered. Anomaly detected.
Another anomaly. The asteroid 333P is emitting some form of radiation controlled burst. It's something trying to communicate with us. Well, please research that, my friend. We have completed the research of echo simulation, which is very good. And now we need... Well, maybe we could try this one. The energy siphon, which is a new weapon. Or planetary unification, which could be good. It makes people more happy, apparently. Gives us some more influence, which is always good. Oh! A scan of the particularly massive asteroid yields fascinating results. The rock's core is shot through with a network of conductive crystals carrying a weak electric charge. The crew on the fungal carrier Urigal Alfin recognize this matrix as a primitive neural lattice and believe the celestial body to be thinking in some capacity, if not fully sapient. They seek permission to excavate the core and transport it to the nearest orbital station for closer study. We can try, I hope it won't die, but we will try, we will see what happens. And I think... oh no. It dies. But... the crystals... oh no. The core, once coaxed from beneath the crust of the asteroid, does not respond well to the vacuum of space. The fungal carrier's instrument read a sudden energy spike moments before the rocky lump gently but decisively fractures. Large chunks of the conductive mineral are salvaged, but whatever spectral charge animated them is now gone. The crystals are still valuable in their own right. Well, okay, I guess that was a bit sad. So what shall we research? Angus vapor is apparently a valuable resource. Energy siphon would be useful to fight the pirates. But I think planetary unification will be good too. Those bastards taking uranium. Wow, we have discovered artifacts from an ancient alien civilization on Hunteron 4A. Incredibly, this civilization, which is apparently referred to itself as the Cybrex, seemed to have been made up of machines that were linked together in some sort of collective consciousness. The age of the artifacts indicate they were active some 600,000 years ago, in this portion of the galaxy at least, but we have learned nothing of their exact origins. According to a partial data fragment that our scientists managed to extract from one of the artifacts, the Cybrex at some point launched a crusade to destroy all sapient organic life in the galaxy for reasons unknown. Interesting, and also updated. Mildly terrifying. Oh man, yes, they are back here. Continuing being awful. If we take them and
evading hostiles.
Oop. Where? Oh no. More pirates, can you guys just stop? You guys are terrible. Everyone hates you. They're killing the mining station. Ay, 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 this is not going well. I guess we need to build some corvettes. Fight the pirates.
Mining station lost.
Oh man.
Survey complete.
They're stealing our resources, these bunches of pirate scum. They were here. Oh, now are they going back to Dorelion? No, where the heck are they going? They're going somewhere. Well, you can go to Dorelion, maybe. It might be useful if we have some of the corvettes just like patrolling around where the pirates are. And here we have a strange and beautiful Class B star system. There is another one. Potentially habitable planets over here, which are being surveyed.
Construction complete.
Well, we have some more corvettes now, I think. And we have another colony ship. I mean, Dorelion is a good system. Even though I might prefer to colonize something out here to sort of spread out a bit. Okay, and one of our leaders has leveled up, that's good.
Anomaly detected.
And we found another anomaly. By chance, we stumble upon a faint alien signal during the survey of this planet. The source appears to be a small object in orbit. The signal contains no message. Could it be a distress transponder? Research, please. And now we can adopt a new tradition. So we can either choose to give us more research alternatives.
Technology discovered.
Yes, I'm definitely choosing the Planetary Survey Corps, because that seems very useful. Our methods of surveying uncharted planetary bodies have continued to improve, and our scans now yield a significant amount of research data that is useful to our scientists. Gain research points equal to a tenth of our monthly gain. Oop. An abandoned life pod was detected in close orbit of Aquilum 1. It's covered in scorch marks, presumably from when the pod's mothership exploded, and preliminary scans suggest it was built more than 5,000 years ago. The crew of the fungal carrier managed to open the pod, revealing the withered remains of a reptilian alien clad in a resplendent uniform. Clutched in one of its claws was a small picture of another individual from the same race, possibly a mate or a revered leader. Aww, that's very sweet. Let's pick the planetary survey, which means that we will gain research much faster. And now, I think that we will just make it so we can build faster. I think that will be good. I mean, coil guns are also useful. They are nice weapons. But I think it's also good to learn to build. We're not growing a lot of food at the moment.
Evading hostiles.
Oh, you absolute swine. Can we kill them? If I go to the Dorelion, let's see. So, attack, 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 attack. Come on, we should have. At least these guys are military. So how can
survey complete?
Attack them. Okay, they're killing
Fleet
us.
Lost.
They're killing us, and we need to build better ships, I think. Let's see, how do I do this?
Mining station lost.
They're stealing our resources and generally stealing everything we have. Ship design.
All the ships in use within our empire are designed here. New hull sizes and components will be unlocked.
Corvette, let's see. Well, we don't have a lot. Mass drivers are our weapons. And fission reactors, and we don't have a lot of stuff we can put here.
Technology discovered.
Yeah, I guess. Let's see. Okay, so we have learned the planetary unification, which I think is good. Holo temple.
Technology discovered.
Well, why not try the energy siphon? And synchronized defenses, that sounds useful. It's a bit expensive, but Oh, it's for stations. Well, let's try the it's rare, so let's do it. Let's do it. And leaders.
The leaders tab lets us hire, dismiss, and assign idle governors, scientists, admirals, and generals.
Let's recruit some decent admiral. Aggressive, seems good. Yes, my friend. Davafin, I'll recruit you. Now these are not very good. Governors then, do we have anyone? More food, engineering output, good as science. Well, why not?
Anomaly detected.
Ooh, an anomaly. This barren and lifeless world is showing signs of once having supported a biosphere. Please research it. And then I figured that we have a 5-ship military fleet, and I shall assign our admiral as leader. And it might be a good idea to just go out there to Durellion and squash those idiots. Who do you think they are? Ooh. Our detailed survey of Othana 6 has revealed that it may once have supported life in the distant past. There are significant deposits of frozen water at the polar ice caps and beneath the planet's surface. The existence of valley networks suggests that the water may once have flowed freely. Terraforming this planet would theoretically be possible, but we do not just yet possess the technology to accomplish this monumental task within a realistic time frame. Fascinating. Well, if you lot go to Durellion, then that would be nice. If I choose all of you and say just go there. We're running low on energy again, but that's just because of those, you know.
Survey complete.
Bloody pirates. In fact, I think I'm going to build a frontier outpost as well here. Just so we can be sure that this will is part of our space and they cannot come.
Mining stations are used to extract them.
You know. Fleet order cancelled. Well, I guess because it is a hostile fleet. Okay. And we have a lot of inactive buildings. So if I choose them and choose attack them. Attack, please. Now we have quite a few ships, so let's see, they have military power. I mean, they're killing the mining station. But our ships, which is stronger, should be able to kill them. Hopefully, I hope, at least. Go on. Yes. Yes, you can do it. We did it. And we need a science ship to go here and research. So if I choose this science ship and say go, let's see. Go to that and then
survey complete.
Ooh, some kind of unknown structures are floating in this gas giant upper atmosphere. They appear to be using aerostatic lift to remain buoyant. Please research that. And some unemployed population. Who could that be? Ooh. Well, we can go here and let's build something. Like a basic power plant. Or maybe we always need minerals, but Well, maybe a temple, actually. I mean, why not, eh? Pridanis could use a temple, I think. Can you please research it? Oh, it's because it doesn't have a scientist. I'll need to recruit. A ruined network of Airset colonies dating back at least 3 millennia can be found in low orbit of this gas giant. Their original function appears to have been gas mining, but they have since been abandoned and reoccupied by many different races and pirates groups. Their colonies have been thoroughly stripped of anything even remotely valuable, but the mere fact that they are still aloft after all this time makes them an interesting subject of engineering research. Fascinating. And let's recruit some scientist. Someone who's good at biology, someone who is maniacal sounds good. Okay, and I would like to choose this young maniac. And please research this.
Construction complete.
And now we finished building this temple. Oh, he's extra happy because he's an immigrant. That's good.
Construction complete. Debris analyzed.
Hooray, we've analyzed the debris. That's good. We have some extra research now. We're still running low on energy credits, though. And this science ship isn't doing much. We could try surveying this planet, I suppose. Let's see.
Anomaly detected.
Ooh, an asteroid in orbit. Interesting. Class 12 asteroid orbits this planet. The small planetoid's orbit appears far too stable for its presence to be a natural occurrence. Research it, my friend, please. Let's see, how do I... survey. How do I survey the system? Do I have to just... No distinguishing features were found on the small asteroid that had seemingly been in orbit. Oops. Well, that sucks. Oh well. How do I... survey... Okay. Has this been surveyed too? Okay, it has, and this I think has been surveyed too, so
survey complete.
Survey that system maybe? What system? Let's go around surveying, I guess. I mean, why not? We have our construction ship in the Relium and some stuff here in Favoterra. And some stuff in Arrakis. But I guess that it would be quite useful to build a mining station out here maybe, yeah. So we can get the energy. And then set the military to
address it. Complete. Technology discovered.
Oh hey, now we know how to make synchronized defenses. Good, good, good. We could reach out to more. Automatic exploration, that sounds very good. Map the stars, yes please. Since we like exploring.
Technology discovered.
And we have completed the research of assembly patterns. Very good. Now... afterburners will make our ships much faster.
Technology discovered.
A large impact crater has been discovered that does not seem to be a natural occurrence. Research it, please. Nuclear missiles for spaceport. Destroyers. Nanocomposite armor. Afterburners. Well, let's try nanocomposite armor. And... a new metal! Detailed surface scans of Dirban 1A have identified a large impact crater containing the wreckage of several ancient starships of unknown design. The ships appear to be completely devoid of life support systems, leading us to suspect that they were either unusually large drones or controlled by some form of artificial intelligence. Interestingly, the hull of the ships was constructed out of living metal, an exceedingly rare and inorganic material with many unique properties. This metal can be programmed to assume a certain shape or form, and it will slowly regrow itself if damaged. Over a period of several millennia, the surviving metal from the wrecked ships was fused into a large and extremely dense deposit that could potentially be mined for centuries to come. Fascinating! Well, planetary resurfacing? I mean, why not? It's the cheapest. Or maybe Angus Vapor, because... Yeah, why not? Let's try it. Let's see what happens. Ooh! And we have found the primitive alien civilization on Uldara in the Durakus system. They're presently in what would be considered a late medieval age, with a firm grasp of metallurgy and a feudal society. The printing press is accelerating the spread of knowledge. We should consider building an observation post above their world to study them more closely. Interesting. Very interesting. Where are they? Oh, out there.
Anomaly detected.
And we have found some sort of tracking beacon. Well, please research that, my friend. I think it's time we pick our construction ship and fly out there.
Survey complete.
Well, we can build a frontier outpost. Let's do that. That means that this planet will be a part of our system. And here in Pudanus, we can... A small short-range transmitter has been located on the servers of Diriban 2. It appears to be an ancient survey marker, placed here eons ago to mark a large deposit of precious metals. The miners it was meant for evidently never arrived, as the deposit is still here. We do need more energy. And we always need more research. Oh, we need a planetary administration, which requires at least 5 people on the planet.
Survey complete.
I guess we could try to build something here, like maybe, I don't know, a power plant. That's always useful. And we have a colony ship that's not doing anything. This
anomaly
one?
Detected.
Valone is 1A seems to exhibit one and only one interesting geological feature. We'll research it. This planet seems okay. Habitability 60%, so it's best if we send an jetty out there on Aculum and on Thermo.
Construction complete.
Again, 60%. It has unstable plate tectonics and bizarre weather. Well, okay, but I mean, at least we can go there, I guess. I mean, that's always a good one. Nothing of interest. A thorough geological survey of Valonis 1A by the fungal carrier Mognova Avab, that's our new science ship, reveals nothing of interest. In fact, it is extraordinarily uninteresting. Its only defining feature is its lack of defining features. There are depressions and elevations, yes, but on the whole, the surface of Valonis 1A can be regarded as unnaturally flat. Likewise, the native flora and fauna are strikingly docile and unworthy of attention. That's good, yeah, I guess. I suppose. Wow, we really cannot live there. It has very bad habitability. So people will feel terrible. But it's a good planet, eventually. Maybe. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I think I will end my episode right here. It was great, and I'll see you guys soon. I hope you have fun out there in space.